Well, it was the classic crime series that made dashing Tom Selleck a household name. And 42 years after Magnum PI first burst onto the small screen, Tom's talented TV sidekick, the wonderful Larry Manetti, is spilling the secrets on what really happened behind the scenes. And he also dishes on some of his fabulously famous friends. Here is my exclusive Studio 10 chat with the ever-charming Larry Manetti. Larry Manetti, so loved as Rick Wright, the trusty sidekick to Tom Selleck's Magnum PI, is celebrating 50 years in the biz.
Sure you don't want to go diving with me?
No, no. I'm gonna stay right here with the emergencies.
I've never done a television show as good and great as Magnum PI. They hit all the buttons. And I don't think you're ever gonna see a classic TV show like that again.
It was early in Larry's blossoming showbiz career that he received some wise counsel. That as an actor, he should spend his time in studio cafeterias and, who knows, he might just nab a gig.
Hang around in the commissary. You'll be able to look at all the beautiful actresses and maybe a producer will want to ask you if you'd like to do a show. And lo and behold, Jack Webb rushed in because he had just fired the entire cast of Chase. And he grabbed my shoulder and he said, "Are you an actor?" And I said, "Yes, sir."
From 1976 to 1978, Larry starred in the hit military series Bar Bar Black Sheep alongside Robert Conrad, a towering actor who became a mentor and lifelong friend.
If it weren't for Robert Conrad, we would not be doing this interview. He was very, very good to me. I owe him my career.
I want everybody and snap your fingers now.
Bar Bar Black Sheep also starred Red West, a close friend, former bodyguard, and confidant of Elvis Presley's. Red had penned a heartfelt but ultimately explosive tell-all about the King. Red had tried in vain to get Elvis off the pills, but sadly, it fell on deaf ears and was too late.
The public really didn't know that Elvis had a problem with drugs, and they were even more shocked. I knew immediately that it was narcotics, and Red knew. And that's what the book basically was about, is to get Elvis to wake up.
In the 80s, along came a show that would change Larry's life. It was Magnum PI, a series about a private investigator set in Hawaii. Now, at first, Larry said no. That is, until he realised who was set to play Thomas Magnum.
I said, "Well, who's starring in it?" He said, "Oh, it's a new guy." I said, "I'm out." He said, "No, it's a guy named Tom Selleck." The week before this phone call, I did the Rockford File with Tom Selleck. And when I put that together in my little brain, I said, "Tom Selleck, you got a deal." I knew immediately this guy was gonna take off.
See you later, Tom.
Rick.
What?
That guy's a gun.
A gun?
Yeah, you know, bang, bang, kills people.
That's how he fishes.
What is the real Tom Selleck like, Larry? Because you two became the best friends, still are, and he's very shy of media, so I guess his fans don't really get to know a lot about him.
His persona is shyness. He's 6'4", he's gorgeous. He has to know it, or he'd be a moron.
Larry spills the tea on what really happened behind the scenes on Magnum PI in his wonderfully candid memoir, Aloha Magnum. Did Tom Selleck's moustache require a lot of fuss? Did it have its own hair and makeup department?
It was perfect. It was precision. He was always twisting it or messing with it.
Is this true, and you would know, that Tom Selleck was actually offered the role of Indiana Jones before Harrison Ford, but there was a schedule conflict, I think, with Magnum PI and the shooting of Indiana Jones, and the rest is history.
Universal Studio said, "You're under contract." When a major studio has you under contract, It's like being set in cement. You are dead meat. And they just said, well, we'll give you a whip once in a while.
Larry's Rolodex is a who's who of Hollywood. And for most of his life, he had a close friendship with old Blue Eyes, Frank Sinatra.
Start spreading the news.
I met Frank Sinatra when I was 12 years old, and I was caddying for a country club. I think it was Medina, I don't remember. And when we finished, he gave me $100, and I said, I'll never forget you, Mr. Sinatra. And he said, well, if you ever get to Hollywood, look me up. I did.
And Larry says that despite the tough tabloid headlines, Frank was a real softie at heart.
Did he have a temper? You bet. The temper and viciousness I saw once. And they made it out that Frank was this ugly, horrible man. And it's not true.
I've got you under my
skin. We were in a hotel and walking down the corridor, and a woman came around and said, Mr. Sinatra, can I speak to you? And she said, my husband's dying. And he has cancer. It would mean so much to me if you would write him a note. And then he took off solid gold cufflinks with diamonds in them, handed the diamond cufflinks to the woman and said, sell these, honey, it'll help you out.
You think about the 8-year run of Magnum PI. Some of the greatest stars in the world guested on that show. You got on with everybody and everybody loved you. But surprisingly, there is one, and it boggles my head.
My God, J.B. Fletcher.
And that is the great Angela Lansbury. For some reason, you just didn't feel any love from her, is that right?
You got it. She never said a word. When you do close-ups, another actor stands behind the camera and reads the lines to you, and he gives his expressions. If it was time to go, she did not do that.
I'm sure that normally you're very good at what you do.
If I wrote a book, she'd be a blank page.
Magnum PI, like so many other classic series, has been given a reboot, which is now in its fourth season. And Larry has some exclusive news to share with his fans down under.
That's the news. I'm going to be part of the cast of the next season.
Larry Manetti, it has been an absolute joy to chat to you, and I do hope one of these days you and Nancy find your way here to Australia, because you've got many fans, and I know right now they're going to be racing out to snap up Aloha Magnum.
Hello, Australia. I love you all, and I love you.
Oh, look, he was such fun, such a charmer, so cheeky. And, of course, he also revealed in the chat, I don't think it made it into the cut there, the real reason that Magnum finished on air, because it was such a hit. That was because Tom Selleck wanted to try his luck on the big screen in the movies, and so he said farewell to Magnum PI. And well, it's interesting because rumours swept around for a long time that Larry Manetti and the great Michelle Pfeiffer had a bit of a something going on. And I did pose that to Larry, and he said, no, absolutely not. We were great friends, but we did not wind up in the bedroom. So he hosed that one well and truly down, and I don't think we could have gotten through the day without knowing that. But lovely, 74 years young, spry as can be, and a career that just keeps on keeping on.
Beautiful. Lucky we didn't see Magnum's PI with those short shorts, isn't it?
Oh, no. They were very short.
There you go, huh?
They were very tight, weren't they?
Yeah, they were. Good man, Craigie.
Lovely. Great to chat. See you in a minute.
Take care.
Thank you.